Okay. So, here class, in vector subtraction, kindly inform me if choppy. So, vector subtraction class, obviously, we are trying to get the difference of a two vector. So, the last time that we have discussed vector addition. So, two given two vectors, you will try to add it. But in this case, we have to subtract it. So, what will be the process? So, in our vector addition, we have used the head-to-tail method, right? Where we draw first the first vector before drawing the second vector. And then, we draw from the tail of the first vector up to the tip of the second vector so that we can get the resultant. Diba? That's how we apply the vector addition or we do the vector addition. So, paano naman if we are trying to subtract? Okay, how can we apply that head-to-tail method? So, by the way, dyan sa page 14, may figure tayo, no? Okay, I'll just share para makita ninyo. Ayan, can you see it now? Kita?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so still the same.
Yes, ma'am.
We are given two vectors, vector A and vector B. So let's say, for example, we are asked to find the difference of A and B. So we have here A minus B or vector A minus B. So how are we going to get this one? Kasi yung alam lang natin is vector addition. Yun nga, head to tail. Okay? So although class, no, like you said, vectors ito, so we cannot simply get it arithmetically. So we have to draw the vectors itself. So, kung ma-observe din yung class, sa vectors, like we have said, negative indicates what? Ano nga yung ini-indicate ng negative? Ha? Pag vector?
Direction na.
Okay, it's a direction. So, kung halimbawa, yung vector A mo is paganito, to the right, okay? Ito yung vector A. So, ano naman pag negative A? Ano ibig sabihin nun? Ha? Ano? Kung yung vector A mo is, halimbawa lang, for example,
opposite direction.
Okay. It means that it is in the opposite direction. So, kung halimbawa, ito yung vector A mo to the right, then, pag inask ka kung ano yung negative A, vector A, then, to the left siya. So, ganito mo siya idodraw. Nakuha nyo? So, simply, yung negative of a vector means when you add it to the original vector, it will give you zero. Or simply the opposite. Kasi katulad nito, kung nakikita nyo dito sa ano na to, sa equation na to, vector A plus the negative of that vector is equal to zero. Kasi nga, oh, if you do this like this, if you drew like that, ito yung vector A. Oh, tapos ito naman yung vector negative A. Negative A ito, tapos ito yung vector A. Oh, if you add that, using the vector addition, what will happen? Diba? It will cancel or magiging zero siya. Bakit magiging zero, ma'am? Eh kasi nga, kung ma-observe nyo, they are in opposite direction. Eh diba, when we apply head to tail, sabi natin, first draw the first vector. So ito, first vector, A. Tapos, draw from the tip of the first vector, draw the second vector. Eh, paano yung second vector mo is eto. Same magnitude, pero opposite direction. So, what will happen? From here, i-redraw mo siya. Ayan. Oh. So, ano dyan yung magiging, ano mo, ano yung magiging resultant mo? O, ngayon class, paano na tayo mag-draw ng resultant? 'di ba? From the tail of the first vector. Saan yung tail ng first vector mo? 'Di ba? Ito oh. Ito. Tama? Plus, saan yung tail ng first vector mo? Di ba ito? Plus. Nawala naman yung connection ko. Okay. Wait lang. Hello class, nawala na naman yung signal. Hello.
Ma'am.
Hello ma'am, nawala ka po ma'am.
Nawala na naman. Oo.
Ma'am.
Nawawala yung signal dito sa school. Saan ako nag saan niyo ako nawala na or na ano? Nag-stop yung discussion ko. Saan nag-stop?
Yung zero na nasagot pag in-add yung negative.
Ah, ano ba? Okay. So, eto oh. Hindi kayo nakaabot dito sa drawing ko. Eto, hindi kayo naabot dito. Kita niyo pa yung screen.
Walang share screen mo.
Ano? Walang share screen. Ayan. Andiyan na.
Diyan pa lang po sa may dalawang araw ko.
Ito pa lang, yung puro black, ito?
Yes po.
Ah, okay. Okay, so
yes po,
ulit
yes
ako
po.
Ha, ulit ako. Okay, so like I've said, let's say ito yung vector A, itong sa right. Tapos, ito naman to the left, yung opposite niya. Eh, when we apply class, the head to tail, ano nga sabi natin? Sabi natin, when applying the head to tail first, draw the first vector. So, ito yung first vector mo. So, this is your vector A. Diba? Now, if you add another vector, so you should start drawing from the tip. O, asan ba yung tip ng vector A mo? Ito yung vector, yung tip ng vector A mo. Diba? And then, i-connect mo dyan. E kaso, yung vector, yung pangalawang vector mo is the negative. So, pag ganun siya, pa-opposite. So, i-draw mo like this. Nakuha? Class? Ngayon, if we add that, okay, applying the vector addition, sabi natin, the resultant is from the tip of the tail of the first vector, eto yung tail, and then, saan magsastop? Saan magsastop? Yung
sa tail
sa tip tail of the first up to the tip of the second, dama? Tail of the first hanggang sa tip ng second. Can you recall yung head to tail? Ha?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, eh asan ba yung tip ng second? Di ba dito din? Di ba? Same location, right?
Yes ma'am.
So therefore, ano yung magnitude ng resultant mo if that's the case?
Zero.
Zero. Okay. That's why, like I've mentioned, if you add or when getting the negative of a vector, ayan nga, when you add the negative vector to the original vector, the resultant is zero. Kasi eto nga siya, oh. Okay. So that means class, from this, we can conclude that when doing the vector subtraction, so we simply get the opposite of that. O katulad niyan, A minus B. Okay? So since wala naman tayong process ng actual na subtraction, wala tayong ganito eh, wala tayong head-to-tail method ng subtraction. So, para ma-apply natin yung head-to-tail, so we will simply apply the addition. Okay? So, para maging addition to, so anong gagawin mo sa negative na to? So, you will factor out. Para maging positive siya, so simply, magiging negative B. Ayan. Magiging ganito yung situation natin. So, kung ma-observe nyo, plus negative is the same rin, di ba? Plus times negative, magiging negative din siya. Pero, bakit ginawa natin plus to? Kasi, like you said, we are trying to apply the vector addition. Nakuha nyo, class? That's why, when doing the vector subtraction, like I've said, you have to get the opposite. So, in this case, negative of vector B. Okay, balik tayo sa figure. So, halimbawa, class, this is our vector A. Ito. Wait lang. Example ba tayo last time ng vector A tsaka B? Warang wala. Okay, eto. Kasi final na to, itong figure na to eh. Kung ma-observe yun dito, A minus B. Ayan. Baliktad to, class. Ano ma-observe yun dito? Ito yung resultant, di ba? Class, ito yung resultant. Yung C.
Yes, po.
Oo. Pero ano yung ma-observe nyo sa direction ng arrow? Kung ma-observe nyo, it's from the tip of the second vector, yung B, papunta sa tip din ng A. Tama? Tip to tip siya. So, hindi siya head to tail. Nakuha nyo?
Yes, ma'am.
Di ba supposedly, sabi natin sa vector addition, it should be from tail of the first to tip of the second. Ayan. Is A, dito sa A minus B, di ba yung first should be A. So, dapat, andito siya. Tapos, dapat mag-end siya dito. Diba? Supposedly. O, pero in this case, your C is tip-to-tip. Bakit ganyan? Kasi nga, we are having the subtraction. So, paano yan, ma'am? Paano natin makikita yung head-to-tail? Okay. So, kung ma-observe nyo dito, class, we have to get first etong opposite ng B. Ano ba yung opposite ng vector B dito? Ito yung ano, vector B. Saan dyan yung ano? Or how are you going to draw the opposite of that? Pag ganito lang, oh. Pababa. Or simply 180 degrees ba, class? I-draw nyo lang ng 180 degrees. So, delete ko muna to. Ito lang siya. This is the opposite or this is the negative B. Okay? The negative B. Pero class, sabi natin, di ba, when applying the vector B, when applying the head to tail, dapat dito ka mag-start sa tip ng vector A. So, dapat ganito. Dito dapat location ng vector, a negative vector B mo. Can you follow? So, if that is the case, saan ngayon yung vector C mo, supposedly? Or if you add vector A plus vector B. So, again, from the tail of A, eto yung tail ng A. Eto. At eto yung tip ng second. So, dapat ganito yung vector C natin. So, this will be your vector C. So, A plus the negative of B. So, this is already supposedly our vector addition. Although, class, eto naman, tama siya to. Can you follow, class? Tama siya to. Kaso, like you said, wala tayong formula on how to get or paano natin ma-execute yung A minus B. Diba? Class? Hello, class? Hello, class. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Sabi natin,
yes, ma'am.
Sabi natin, wala tayong method to execute the subtraction. So, yung ginawa natin, okay? So, ginawa nating positive yung operation. So, dapat A plus, tapos itong negative B, ginawa mong ganyan. Okay? So, parang ma-execute mo to, no? So, eto, papalitan mo to. Etong B, kukunin mo yung negative niya. So, like you said, yung negative niya, supposedly, is eto, dito. Diba? Eto tapos supposedly yung vector, negative vector B. E kaso, sabi natin, when drawing, or when applying the head to tail, dapat ano mo siya, i-connect mo siya to your first vector. Eto yung first vector mo, yung vector A. That's why, class, dito ko siya kinonect. Nafa-follow nyo ba? Ha? Nafa-follow hindi?
Medyo lag po yung screen, ma'am.
Asaan? Ano pa lang yung ano, nakadraw?
Okay na po, ma'am. Diyan naman po. Pero minsan kasi po hindi ma-follow
okay.
Yung ano.
Ah, okay, okay.
Sinusulat.
Ah, okay. Pero nama-follow nyo, kung naiintindihan nyo kung bakit ganyan yung position ni negative B? But andyan ko siya din knowing?
Yes,
po, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. How about yung...
Opposite.
How about etong C? Bakit dito ko siya din knowing, naiintindihan nyo? Ha? Naiintindihan
yes, po, ma'am.
Okay, very good.
Yes, ma'am.
Para ma-apply ko yung head to tail.
Okay, very good. So, therefore, class, when getting, okay, when getting the value of A minus vector B, okay, so this is the answer, or this will be your answer here. You have to execute this one. Okay? So, again, kahit addition yan, kahit subtraction yan, still, we are using the vector addition. Yun nga lang, we are getting the negative of the second vector para ma-execute natin yung vector addition. Gets hindi?
Gets, ma'am.
Okay.
Crystal clear, ma'am.
Okay, okay. By the way, what if ganito naman? I-erase ko to, ha? Ah, by the way, screenshot niyo muna to, class. Screenshot nyo nga muna to. Mag-erase muna ako. Okay na? Okay na? Na-screenshot na?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I-erase ko muna, ha? Oo. Para mas maintindihan ninyo yung mga... kuan natin dito. Kung naintindihan ba talaga yung vector addition and all. Okay. So, tignan, mag-focus tayo, class, sa arrow. Kasi, di ba, yung arrow, yan yung magsasabi sa atin kung eto ba, first vector ba to, or second vector ba to, or resultant ba to. Remember, class, that a resultant, okay, madidistinguish mo siya na resultant siya, resultant, if the arrow is from the tail and to tip. Yan, tingnan mo ha. Oh, based from this definition. Okay, look at the triangle. Okay, look at the triangle. Anong vector diyan yung from tail to tip siya? Is it vector A, vector B, or vector C? Oh, sige nga.
Vector B, ma'am.
Okay, it's the vector B. Sino yon? Si Umapa. Sino yon? Palomo. Sino yon?
Palomo, ma'am.
Okay, it's Palomo. Okay, very good. So, the answer is vector B. Kasi kung titingnan nyo, class, yung vector B, oh, from the tip, ay yung tail pala. Ito yung tail. Tail of A to the... Ay, wait.
Wala, ma'am.
Wala.
Vector A, ma'am.
C, ma'am.
It should be A pala. I'm sorry. It should be A. Ayan, oh. From, si A from the tail and then to the tip. Tama? So, dapat si A. I'm sorry, Palomo. Dapat A. Ayan, oh. Tail to tip. Yung hinahanap natin. Tail to tip. Ito. Ito yung tail ng first vector. And then, ito yung tip. So kung i-imagine ninyo, naunang denoting si B. Ayan, oh. Tapos, kinonect si C. Ganyan. Tapos, para makuha si resultant, eto siya, vector A, from tail to tip. Tama kaya? Kung titignan nyo, class, yung ano natin, yung equation, eto yung equation. So, if you transpose, okay, nagawin siyang vector addition, anong mangyayari? If you transpose B to the right side, so magiging C plus B equals A, which is correct. Inadd natin yung B tsaka C, yung resultant is A. Or pwede rin, since commutative, di sabi natin commutative yung vector addition, so pwedeng yung i-transpose mo rin, or pwedeng isulat na B choppy plus C. Ay, I'm sorry. Kanina pa, Choppy? Kanina pa? Kanina pa, Choppy class?
Mga 30 seconds pa naman.
Mga 30 seconds, okay. Saan niya na naputol yung ano, yung sinasabi ko?
Sa pag-ubat equation, ma'am.
Ah, sa paggawa. Ito, transpose lang sa class. Ayan, oh. Ayan. So, makikita niyo yan. Like I've said, kung halimbawa figure lang yung given sa inyo, hanapin niyo lang yung arrow. Dapat yung arrow ng vector na yan is drawn from the tail to tip para masabi mo siya na resultant siya. Okay? Yan lang yung ano mo. Tapos, out of that or based from that, makakagawa ka ng equation. Katulad yan. Tulad din nito. Okay? Basta kastandaan nyo na yung operation natin is always vector addition. So, if ever na may negative dyan, so, i-factor out nyo lang, gawin nyo lang positive, tapos, yung negative na yun, gawin nyo siyang negative of a vector, which is simply the opposite. Okay? Ganyan lang. Naintindihan ba dito sa ano na to? Sa figure natin? Eto. Meron tayong example para mas maklaro. Give the negative of the following vectors.
Yes.
So, pinapahanap lang class yung negative. Class? Choppy ba? Choppy? Hello? Okay ba?
Hindi pa, ma'am.
Hindi? Hindi. Okay. Choppy pa rin?
Okay naman po. Okay naman.
Okay
po.
Naman. Okay. So, example 20.
Okay man, ma'am.
Okay, very good. Example 20 tayo. Kunin daw natin yung negative of the following vector. So, sa vector A muna tayo. So, vector A, 2 units north. So, yung direction niya, class, is north. No? So, what is? So, if vector A is 2 units north, then what is the negative A? Ah, sige nga.
2 units south lang.
Okay, very good. Simply, 2 units south. Ganun lang, class. That's already the negative of a vector. How about this vector B? If vector B is 4 units, 30 degrees south of west, okay? So, para mas klaro or maintindihan natin yung location ng 30 degrees south of west, mas mabuting i-drawing natin. Ito yung north, west, and south. So, saan located yung 30 degrees south of west? Ito, no? Ito? Tama?
Yan lang.
Okay. So, therefore,
third quadrant map.
To get the negative, simply draw dito. Opposite natin dito. Ayan. Ilan to?
30 din.
30 din yan. Okay. So, therefore, what is the negative B? Sige nga. Negative B.
30 degrees north of east.
No. 4 units.
4 units.
4 units.
30 degrees.
30 degrees.
North of east.
North okay. of east.
North of east. Ganun lang. Marunong na?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, sige.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's try ito namang dalawang vectors na. So we'll be getting the subtraction or the difference of two vectors. Ito naman, given 6 units east and 4 units west. Okay, i-drawing natin class para mas ano siya, mas klaro yung location. So 6 units east. So this is the first vector ha. By the way, we are trying to determine A minus B. So, ito yung ipa-follow nating formula. A plus the negative of B. Do you follow? Again, when getting A minus B, ito yung ipa-follow nating formula. Para ma-ano natin yung head to tail. Ma-apply natin yung head to tail, ha? Okay. So, let's first draw. This is for letter A first. Are you still there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so for letter A, so I will first draw the first vector, which is 6 units east. So saan ulit si 6 si east? Ito no, sa left? Ay, no, sa right pala. No? Ito?
Yes, right, ma'am.
Okay, ito si vector A.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, plus 4 units west. So supposedly, saan yung west? Dito sa left. Tama?
Sa left po.
Sa left. So, supposedly, eto siya. Eto. I-draw, ano ko lang ha? I-draw, pero hindi ito yung final. Eto, supposedly, sino mas mahaba? A or B? Si B. Ay, no, si A pala. Eto, supposedly, si B. Pero,
A, ma'am.
Ha? A yung mahaba. Tama?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, ito supposedly, class ha, yung location ng A tsaka B. Pero, like you said dito, para makuha si A minus B, so we have to add vector A, the negative of B. So, saan yung negative ng B?
It
should be 4 units?
4 units east.
Okay. It should be 4 units east. Dito dapat siya. So, i-draw ko siya, ha? Eto. Eto siya. Negative B. So, therefore, where is our resultant? So, our resultant is simply A minus B, or in this case, A plus negative of B. Saan dyan? Again, we will draw it from the what? Tail of?
From the tip of the A.
From the tail of your, ano nga?
First.
Ay, A, ma'am. I'm sorry. Di pala dito, ba't dito natin drawing yung B natin? Dapat dito pala natin siya i-connect. I'm sorry. Ito yung A, tapos i-connect natin yung B natin. So, ganito dapat
tip
siya.
Ma'am.
Ayan, tip. So, negative B dapat ito. Okay. So, sabi natin, the resultant should be from the tail of the first towards what?
The tip.
The tip of the second. Ito, tip of the second. Ito siya. Ayan. So, what will be? Ano ma-observe nyo? Ilan yung magnitude niya? Ito is 6, tapos ito is 4. Since same direction sila, what will happen? That would be? Okay. So, magiging 10 units, what?
East.
Okay. So, 10 units east na lang siya. That's already the value of your A minus B. Nakuha? Nakuha, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
How about for letter B naman? For letter B. For letter B, 7 meters, 60 degrees Newton of east. Okay, let's try this one. north and this is east. 60 degrees is like this. Tama? 60 degrees. So this is your vector A. This is 7 meters. How about 5 meters east? Saan yung 5 meters east? Ito naman siya. Supposedly, ito yung 5 meters east ha. Ito supposedly yung B. Pero, ano yung negative niya? Dito dapat, no?
West.
Ito.
Southwest.
Southwest. West. West lang dapat.
So, 5 meters west.
5 meters west. Okay. Okay. So, I will redraw this, ano, this figure. So, pag ganito dapat siya, dito mo i-coconnect yung 5 meters. Ito yung B mo. Okay? So, saan yung resultant natin? From the tail, eto, to the tip, eto dapat yung resultant mo. So, if I redraw this class, ganito dapat siya. Ay, no. Ganito. And, pag ganito. Walang arrow to. Okay. This is...
Ma'am.
Oh.
Ma'am.
Question, ma'am.
Ano yun?
Diba, 60 degrees north of east, tapos yung B niya is 5 meters to east. Ba't po siya nagpapuntang west?
Yung opposite niya.
Kasi may ano, negative.
Negative of so negative. Vector B.
Okay pa.
Oo, kasi we are trying to get A minus B. So originally, yung 5 meters east, eto siya. Pero hindi natin ginagamit yan kasi yung gagamitin natin is the negative. Tama?
Okay pa.
Okay. Taro na? Okay, let's proceed. So, eto, this is 7 meters. This is 5 meters. And this is our resultant. Ayan. By the way, what is this angle? Kung 60 to, right, so ilan to?
30.
Okay, 30.
30, ma'am.
Eto naman, ilan to?
30 din.
Ito, ilan ba to? Ilan to?
90, ma'am.
Okay, 90. So, therefore, this is, ayan o, the same lang yung class. Kung 60 to, 60 din dapat to. Okay, so 60 yan ha. So, we have a 30, 60, 90. Anong triangle ngayon 30, 60, 90? Isosceles ba siya? Ano nga yung 30, 60, 90? Anong klaseng triangle? Isosceles ba? Kalimutan ko na. Basta 30, 60, 90 siya na right triangle. Okay? So, based from that class, paano natin makukuha itong resultant? Ha? Ganito yung itsura niya. Ayan. So, in this case class, you can use the trigonometric identities. You can use the, kasi right triangle eh, you can use sine, cosine, ganyan, tangent. So, since given yung 5 meters and yung hypotenuse natin na 7 meters, ayan. So, pwede natin itong gamitan using the angle. What do you think? Ito o, oh, i-redraw ko lang ha na nakaganito. Ayan. This is your 90. So, this is your R. This is your 5. Binaliktad ko lang ha. Ayan. So, eto yung 30 and this is your 60. Ayan. Anong appropriate or anong gusto nyong gamitin dito? You can use the Pythagorean, no? Oh, let's try Pythagorean theorem. 7 squared, 5 squared, R squared. 7 squared minus 5 squared equals R squared. Ilan to? Square root of 49 minus 25. How much? How much class? 49 minus 25 and get the square root of it.
2 square root of 6.
Huh?
4.59.
But
4.9 meters. O sige. How about if we use the ano, the sine cosine? In this case, class, let's say gamitin mo itong 30 degrees. Okay? Let's say ginamit mo yung 30 degrees. Anong trigonometric identity yung pwede? So, pwede mong gamitin yung opposite kasi opposite siya to. Ng 30 ha? Tingin kayo sa 30. Opposite yung 5. And then, adjacent yung R. Opposite and adjacent. Tangent. Tama? So, pwede na gamitin yung tangent 30. So, yung opposite niya is 5. And yung adjacent niya is R. Abe, try 5 divide tangent 30. How much? Kung parehas siya. Yun, check lang natin. 5 over tangent 30. How much?
5 square root of 8.
8.66, ma'am.
8.66. 8.66, ma'am.
Okay, so 8.66. Okay, tingnan natin na. How about kung gamitin naman natin hypotenuse tsaka adjacent. Ito namang 7 tsaka adjacent. Kung pareha sila. Cosine, no? Cosine 30.
Yes, po.
Adjacent is R and hypotenuse is 7. So, 7 cosine 30. Kasi hindi ako sure kasi klase dito sa Pythagorean to kung tama siya, kung pwede rin magamit. 7 cosine 30. Ay?
6.06.
6.06. Adjacent, hypotenuse. Tama ba? Ka. Adjacent. So, 7 cosine 30. So, mali din. 7. 6 point something din. Iba-iba yung lumalabas. Bakit kaya?
Ma'am, siguro iba-iba. Kasi scale ng triangle.
Ano no?
Kaya siguro iba-iba. Kasi di ba the scale ng height, the unequal length. Kaya magkaiba ba ng length na lang?
Ano man? Anong magkaiba, yung ano?
Yung length daw magkaiba.
Magkaiba yung length? No. Kasi ano, we are trying to check kung pwede bang gamitan ng iba, ng ibang formula ba. Pero what we are trying to solve is yung R pa rin. Sine-check lang natin kung ano. Bakit kaya hindi the same yung ano, yun yung inaano ko, ba't hindi the same? Check natin. Baka may mali tayo sa ano. Okay, ito. Sandali ha.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ano yun ga?
Kasing ang tangent, ma'am, at ang Pythagorean theorem, ma'am. That, pero, yung minus na abin, ma'am, ang a squared at b squared, ma'am. Dapat a squared plus b squared equals to c squared, ma'am.
Ano no? 7 squared? Di ba sa Pythagorean is hypotenuse
ang
squared?
Ang answer is ng tangent, ma'am.
Yung answer ng tangent is, ano?
Answer ng tangent, ma'am, and ng Pythagorean theorem, ma'am, is ng the same, ma'am.
Bakit? 4.9, tsaka 8.6.
A squared plus B squared, ma'am, equals to C squared, ma'am.
Oo. Ay, yung...
5 squared is ng 25.
Ah, mali siya. Ano? Pythagoras.
Bakit?
25 plus 49, ma'am, is 74. 12 plus 74 is
8.60 na yung gagawa, ma'am.
Ay, sino nagsabi ng 4.9 kanina? Dapat 8.66.
Dapat lang may 49 plus 25 square root, ma'am. Agad sa bakit 8.60.
Bakit plus? Kasi, di ba, sa Pythagorean theorem...
Ging transpose man, imaw. Sakto man.
Sakto man, ma'am. 4.9.
Gin sa...
Hindi magiging plus yan. Kasi if you transpose, magiging minus. Kasi sa ano natin, sa Pythagorean, dapat hypotenuse squared... Diba, ito yung ano natin, hypotenuse squared, and then adjacent squared, plus opposite squared. So, in this case, yung hypotenuse mo is 7. Tapos, yung adjacent mo is r, and then yung opposite mo is 5. So, itatranspose mo siya. Pero parang may limitation kasi yung Pythagorean. That's why, inaano ko siya kung tama ba yung Pythagorean, kasi parang hindi. So, tinignan ko dito, class, sa ano ako, sa reference ko. Hindi Pythagorean yung gagamitin, tsaka hindi rin yung mga sine at tsaka cosine. It should be the sine law. Okay, so hindi pa ito 60-30. Bakit hindi 60-30? Kasi 60 newton... 60 degrees Newton, north of east. Tama naman. Ah, okay. Mali yung pagka-drawing ko. So, hindi pa ito 90 degrees, class. I'm sorry, class. Hindi ito 90 degrees. Dapat, ganito pala siya. Kasi hindi naman siya exactly ganito dito sa may ano. So, eto, baka ganito siya. So, mga ganito yung ano natin. So, hindi siya 90 degrees. Ito. So, hindi siya 30-60 o hindi siya right triangle. Ayan. So, therefore, dapat yung gagamitin dito is sine law or cosine law. Class? Hello?